You may already know about our desktop filament extruder, so in today's video I'm going to walk you through the improvements we've made to go from this to this, the superior version in every aspect. So let's begin! Considering the recommendations of many of our users, we have redesigned and upgraded our current Fullextruder model to the new Fullextruder PRO. Since there are not a few, but many new features, we are going to divide the video in several parts so you can fast forward to the area that interests you the most. Let's start with the most important improvement, the nozzle. The machine comes integrated with a 2.5mm diameter brass nozzle for filaments smaller than 2mm. Unscrewing it reveals a 5mm nozzle that can extrude filament up to 4mm in diameter. Since filament is extruded at high pressure and speed, it was necessary to implement a breaker plate to eliminate the axial rotation of the filament. In addition, it comes with a 168μm stainless steel filter to remove dirt and other unmelted particles. Following the filament path, we move on to the cooling system. As you can see, the distance of the path has been increased and several modifications have been made. The first one is that the fan of the previous model has been replaced by 5 turbofans. Instead of being always on, their speed can be controlled from the extruder itself, allowing greater control. In addition, 2 oscillation reducers have been incorporated to ensure a better consistency in the filament. Once passed through the cooling system, the filament reaches the thickness measuring block. This component has a sensitivity of 1 micrometer and is calibrated to obtain diameters ranging from 1mm to 4mm. Allowing us to obtain great filament quality. We are now going to present the most modified part. In the previous model, there was only a moving part rotating on an axis without any feedback, while the new model has a tension sensor to check that the winding speed is correct. To improve the winding quality, a linear movement parallel to the spool has also been implemented, and the tensioning bar has been modified to adapt to each filament size. Like the previous parts, the filament spooler has also been improved. It can handle spools of up to 2.5 kg and reaches speeds from 1 to 30 rpm. As a special improvement, now, in addition to the conventional spools, special spools with changes in the wall's inclination can also be used. This makes it possible to reuse even more types of spools. To be able to control all these parts with the new functionalities and parameters, a 168x64 pixel LCD display has been chosen. If you get an amazing filament and you want to repeat the results, don't worry, you can save the printing parameters. You have up to 5 empty profiles where you can save the values. On the other hand, you can also insert an SD card to save the temporary values obtained in the temperatures and filament thickness variables for each extruding session. In the next video, we will also explain for what these parameters are used for. Please subscribe to not miss any information about the launch of this extruder and upcoming videos. Once each parameter has been configured, 4 possible screens will appear. The first one controls the temperature for each heater, the speed of the extruder motor and the speed of the cooling fans. The second screen controls the parameter of the measuring block, the filament guide and the winder. The third one, all of the important values of the previous screens are displayed at the same time. As can be seen, the LCD display can change color. Colors are used to indicate the status of the machine. In this moment it is orange, which indicates that the extruder is heating up and cannot yet extrude. In the final screen, you can stop the extrusion and save the parameters in the selected profile. In this case, you can see that profile 1 has saved the previous values for future use. We have covered the most important improvements of this new model, but we still have a few more to go. Like the capability of the extrusion hopper, which has been increased to 1 kg of material, providing more autonomy. Other extra improvements we have included are the automatic stop of the extruder motor when it detects a blockage and the use of silent drivers to reduce the motor's noise. We just finished, but there's still a lot of information to discover. For this reason, in the next video, we will show the complete filament extrusion process, explaining in more depth the parameters and some hidden functions of the machine. We also wanted to take this opportunity to inform you that the machine will be available at the crowdfunding platform Kickstarter. So, if you want to be informed, please subscribe to not miss any news. Thank you very much.